Most of you know, when the United States first got its independence, it was comprised of 13 colonies, weak colonies, strung out along the Atlantic seaboard. What happened between 1783 and 1853 is that the United States marched across the continent from the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean and murdered huge numbers of Native Americans, stole their land, went to war against Mexico in the 1840s, and stole what is today the southwest of the United States from Mexico. We invaded Canada in 1812. One of the main reasons we invaded Canada in 1812 was to make Canada part of the United States. The reason that Ottawa is the capital of Canada and Toronto is not the capital of Canada is that the Canadians expected, actually the British who were in charge at the time, expected us to pay a return visit sometime in the 19th century and try to conquer Canada. Today, what is the Caribbean would be part of the United States were it not for the slavery issue. Southern states were desperate to move into the Caribbean and conquer those islands and make them part of the United States. It was the slavery issue and the fact that northern states did not want any more slaveholding states in the Union that prevented us from going further south. The United States had a voracious appetite for conquest and annexation. It's no accident that when Adolf Hitler invaded the Soviet Union on June 22, 1941, from that point forward, for the next 6 months, he frequently talked about the United States as a model state for creating Lebensraum. He often referred to the Volga River as his Mississippi. He understood that the United States was very successful at carving out a huge state in North America.